UWSP has faculty who are national and international experts in their field. They share their passions with the campus and community. The Ethel and Ward Cable Family Heroes Award highlights the great work that our faculty are doing. We are proud to honor them.
I grew up in Stevens Point, a couple of blocks from the university, and my parents were our heroes, were my heroes, but lost my dad when we were quite young, and my mother was really the one that raised us and took care of us and lived a life as a widow for over 60 years. Amazing woman.
And little Ethel will always be an inspiration to me, whether she's living or gone. And I am so happy to be a part of this Heroes Fund. Giving back to the university was always something I think that she would be real pleased about that.
We have had a couple instances where we've found issues, and in those instances, you know, it could be life-changing for some of these athletes. I first started participating in Special Olympics Healthy Hearing when I was a student, actually. I am a clinical director for Healthy Hearing in Wisconsin, for Special Olympics in Wisconsin, but I also have done some work on kind of a national and even global level with Special Olympics. I sit on a global faculty advisory board for Healthy Hearing, so it's people all over the world that are doing kind of what we're doing here in Wisconsin, and the main focus and what I've really been focused on with Special Olympics is the follow-up piece for these athletes. So what we do in Special Olympics is amazing, but when we're done with the screenings, that's kind of where my involvement stopped. And so I would constantly think about, you know, did they get the help that they needed, that we talked about at the games? And so that was a big component that was kind of missing. Within Healthy Hearing, we do otoscopy, so we look in their ears. We do OAEs, which is kind of an objective test that they don't have to respond for, measures the hair cell function in the ear. And then we do the classic hand raise test, and then we also evaluate their middle ear with tympanograms. I bring students to the games and they run the screenings after I train them. It's a great opportunity for them to learn how to work with that population and just get the practice and the experience.
In addition, just the amount of athletes that we go through is hundreds that we see. So it's really great to see so many and kind of see the range of abilities. It's really fantastic.
There's no specific course or standard covered in graduate school that specifically looks at individuals with intellectual disabilities. And it is kind of a special population that you really do need training in working with. And so it's a way to teach students how to be compassionate, how to treat them like the adults that they are, and how to get the results that you need to get in a timely manner, and to really just help them.
You know, they're still just people, and sometimes it feels like we have to be very careful if you haven't had those experiences before. But seeing how Dr. Craig works with people so easily and so naturally is very helpful as well.
Protect your ears. Always wear hearing protection when you're around loud noises. And get your ears checked. I feel like people tend to not think of hearing evaluations like they do other parts of their body. You know, we go to the dentist twice a year. We get our eyes checked once a year. Ears are no different. It's very important that we're checking the status of the ears, at least on a yearly basis. I would have to say my daughter. She's 5 and she can be absolutely feral at times, but she is really my main source of inspiration. She sees the world through a completely different lens than many adults, obviously, and she really inspires me to just be the best person that I can be and make the changes, you know, that I can make, that are feasible, that can help everybody. I'm happy to be a part of Special Olympics. I think it's an amazing organization, and what they do for these athletes is phenomenal, and I'm just happy to be a part of it.